Elon Musk's monumental Starship designed for space exploration, unrivaled in its size and promise. The current iteration is the most substantial launch system ever successfully deployed. Future iterations will be much larger, designed to carry hundreds of people or several tons of payload into space. But here's the rub. SpaceX has been quietly advancing development of Starship. It's far larger than anything we've ever seen before. What incredible potential it could hold. Let's explore in today's NR Studio episode, Space Exploration Technologies Corp. The aerospace innovator founded by Elon Musk has earned praise for transforming the commercial rocket sector. Leveraging revolutionary reusable rocket technology, the company has developed a trend of designing ever larger and more sophisticated launch vehicles over the years. Its current mothership, Starship, represents the largest and most ambitious system in its portfolio. Starship's most recent flight featured Version 1, an engineering marvel that stands an impressive 400 feet tall in its two-stage configuration. That elevates its status beyond the iconic Saturn V rocket. Starship is powered by Raptor engines, renowned for their exceptional thrust-to-weight ratio, setting a benchmark in the industry, establishing SpaceX's leadership in propulsion technology. Looking ahead, SpaceX intends to begin testing the next iteration of Starship, dubbed Version 2, in 2025. With a payload capacity of 100 tons to orbit and significant improvements, particularly in reentry performance, V2 represents substantial progress. A notable improvement in V2 is the reengineering of the front flap system. In previous iterations and concept drawings, the front flaps were positioned 180 degrees apart, mirroring the arrangement of the rear flaps. However, this configuration presented stability issues during descent, as the front flaps generated lift that caused the nose of the vehicle to pitch upward. Additionally, adjustments to compensate for the rear flaps. Although Starship's flaps are retractable, some of the front flaps and static aero components remain open during descent, increasing aerodynamic drag. Although the additional drag benefited the heavier rear section, it proved detrimental to the forward part of the vehicle. Musk recognized this concern in a tweet, remarking, "Incidentally, there is a minor flaw in the design of the forward flap. The forward flaps and V2 have been entirely repositioned. The innovative design situates them on the leeward side of the spacecraft, ensuring that the static aero is predominantly protected from the incoming airflow. Upon retraction, the flaps are effectively obscured behind the nose cone, thereby reducing drag and the opposing side of the vehicle. The initial step involves ensuring the full reallocation of the forward flaps and V2. The innovative design positions them on the leeward side of the spacecraft, thereby optimizing the static nose cone to reduce drag and enhance aerodynamic efficiency. This modification not only addresses the descent stability challenges, but also optimizes overall performance. In addition to the forward flaps, SpaceX has enhanced or upgraded various components in version 2 to bolster both durability and functionality. For instance, enhancements have been made to increase the robustness of the nose cone and header tank, while innovative systems such as the PSOS dispenser for satellite deployment and specialized components for the launch tower's catch mechanism during landings have been seamlessly integrated. These improvements reflect SpaceX's dedication to ensuring that Starship is not only reusable, but also sufficiently resilient to endure multiple missions with minimal upkeep. Nevertheless, SpaceX's aspirations extend far beyond V2. The company is actively strategizing the development of an even grander iteration, designated Starship 5-3. This forthcoming iteration is anticipated to surpass its forerunners in every quantifiable aspect. Anticipated to reach a staggering height of 150 meters, the V3 is poised to be the tallest rocket ever constructed. Exceeding all prior benchmarks, this increased elevation will result in an unparalleled cargo capacity with the potential to double that of V2. To provide context, the construction of the International Space Station necessitated 60 space shuttle missions to transport a total of 20 tons of materials. Membership 5-3 has the capability to achieve the same outcome in merely 2 flights. This colossal rocket will be propelled by a series of Raptor engines, which can produce an astonishing thrust of 10,000 tons at sea level. This exceptional performance capability positions V3 as a formidable asset for both commercial and scientific endeavors, empowering SpaceX to manage larger payloads and undertake more intricate missions than previously possible. One of the most remarkable features of V3 is its pricing. Although one might anticipate that such a sophisticated rocket would carry a substantial price tag, SpaceX endeavors to position it as the most economically efficient rocket ever conceived. Remarkably, the projected launch cost for V3 is estimated to be merely $2 to $3 million, a figure significantly lower than that of Falcon 1. SpaceX's inaugural rocket, which at that time carried a launch cost of $10 million. This significant reduction in cost is attributed to the rocket's full reusability and an optimized design that effectively reduces both refurbishment time and expenses between launches. This newfound affordability possesses the capacity to revolutionize the commercial aerospace sector, rendering space more accessible than it has ever been. With these innovations, Starship V3 signifies a critical juncture in the annals of aerospace history. Its amalgamation of dimensions, performance capabilities, and cost-effectiveness is poised to revolutionize the horizons of space exploration and commercial ventures. SpaceX persistently expands the limits of rocket capabilities, rendering the future of space travel more thrilling and attainable than ever before. Undoubtedly, the present iteration of Starship embodies the zenith of launch systems. However, in Musk's ambitious vision for multiplanetary colonization, there exists no spacecraft that can be deemed excessively large. Musk has now alluded to the upcoming iteration of Starship, boasting an impressive diameter of 18 meters, which is twice the width of the existing model. This enhancement would not only extend its width beyond the first stage of the Saturn V at 10 meters and the Soviet Union's N1 rocket at 17 meters, but would also establish it as the most expansive rocket ever built. Doubling the diameter results in a fourfold increase in cargo capacity for a vehicle of identical height, enabling this variant of Starship to carry quadruple the amount of cargo or passengers compared to the existing model. Envision the feasibility of an entire space station being launched within a single mission. Nevertheless, such an escalation in size necessitates corresponding augmentations in fuel and structural weight, thereby mandating a commensurate significant enhancement in thrust. The existing Super Heavy booster, equipped with 33 Raptor 5-2 engines that generate an extraordinary 230 tons of thrust each, boasts an unmatched capacity for liftoff. Nonetheless, for the 18-meter Starship, SpaceX would probably require in excess of 130 engines. However, there is additional complexity involved. Following the advancements with the 3's thrust, which is already reaching an impressive 280 tons with aspirations for 300 tons, this next-generation Starship has the potential to attain the requisite thrust utilizing fewer engines. Musk may potentially unveil a larger engine featuring a more powerful turbine, thereby simplifying the complexity and maintenance associated with overseeing hundreds of engines per flight. One might question the rationale behind constructing such an immense rocket. However, the response is intricately linked to SpaceX's overarching ambition of establishing a human settlement on Mars. Establishing a permanent settlement on Mars will necessitate the transportation of substantial cargo volumes and the relocation of thousands of individuals. SpaceX anticipates the deployment of thousands of Starships throughout each 26-month window designated for Mars transfers. Nonetheless, this ambitious initiative necessitates the execution of thousands of orbital tanker missions solely for the purpose of refueling these vessels in space. It presents a logistical challenge of unparalleled magnitude. However, an expanded Starship has the potential to greatly streamline this procedure. Indeed, Musk's 2016 proposal for an interplanetary transport system, characterized by a diameter of 12 meters, subtly suggested his ambitions to extend beyond the existing parameters of the Starship. A version measuring 18 meters could accommodate 4 times the payload capacity, thereby minimizing the fleet of Mars-bound Starships from approximately 1,000 to merely 250. In a similar vein, the quantity of tanker flights may decrease by more than 3,750, which could essentially render orbital refueling depots obsolete. This expansion would not only enhance the viability of Mars colonization, but also optimize resource management for lunar expeditions. Establishing a sustainable colony on Mars necessitates far more than simply transporting individuals. Transportation of infrastructure, habitats, food supplies, and equipment must be conducted in significant quantities. An expanded Starship would adequately satisfy these requirements, facilitating a reduction in launch frequency and guaranteeing that the settlement possesses all essentials for sustained survival. Furthermore, the 18-meter Starship holds the potential to transform lunar missions by transporting an entire base infrastructure in a single voyage, thereby expediting humanity's pursuit of a sustained presence on the Moon, particularly for the United States and its allied nations. However, let me clarify, this next-generation Starship transcends mere dimensions. The 18-meter Starship, with its remarkable cargo capacity, advanced thrust, and groundbreaking efficiency, is set to revolutionize space exploration and expand the frontiers of possibility. Regardless of whether the destination is Mars, the Moon, or the farthest reaches of space, this monumental spacecraft has the potential to transform humanity's position within the universe. Given these remarkable benefits, one might wonder why SpaceX has yet to construct this colossal version of Starship. The explanation resides in the significant intricacies and challenges presented by such an endeavor. A Starship with an 18-meter diameter would represent a fundamentally distinct vehicle, necessitating significant alterations throughout all phases of development and operation. To commence, SpaceX would require a novel production facility specifically designed to accommodate its substantial dimensions. This would require the construction of more expansive megabays, enlarged tank farms, and reinforced steel rings of greater thickness than those currently employed. The infrastructure for launch and testing necessitates a comprehensive reimagining. The current launch pad and water dilution system are insufficient to manage the heat and vibrations generated by the simultaneous firing of 130 Raptor engines. Although SpaceX demonstrates a commendable history of swiftly enhancing its systems, attaining the requisite robustness for such an immense rocket presents a significant challenge. A pertinent example is Starship's existing Mechazilla launch tower, engineered to capture both Starship and its super heavy booster upon their descent. Nonetheless, seizing a vehicle that is four times larger and heavier than the existing Starship would prove to be exceedingly challenging. A viable alternative could involve completely abandoning the tower and returning to the conventional landing approach. Moreover, transportation presents an additional considerable challenge. Currently, there are no routes sufficiently expansive to accommodate a vessel of this magnitude. To tackle this issue, SpaceX should aim to reduce transportation necessities by constructing and launching the rocket directly from its production facility. The most significant obstacle, nonetheless, is of a bureaucratic nature. The deployment of a rocket of such significant scale necessitates extensive environmental testing and the attainment of regulatory approval over several years. Concerns such as shockwaves, emissions resulting from combustion, and human safety necessitate thorough assessment prior to the clearance of such a colossal rocket for operational deployment. The concept of a spacecraft of such magnitude may appear to be a lofty aspiration, yet it is indeed grounded in historical precedents. In the year 1962, Captain Robert C. Truax, a rocket engineer serving in the United States Navy, put forth an ambitious proposal for an expansive spacecraft known as the Sea Dragon. Standing at 150 meters in height and boasting a diameter of 23 meters, the Sea Dragon was a formidable two-stage sea-launched orbital super-heavy lift vehicle. It has the incredible capability of lifting 550 metric tons, equivalent to 1.2 million pounds, into low Earth orbit, making it one of the most robust launch systems ever designed. Truax aimed to develop a cost-effective, heavy-lift launcher that would demonstrate efficacy and affordability. This principle, referred to as the Big Dumb Booster, emphasized reduced operating expenses. Truax had a vision that was advanced for its time. To realize this vision, Truax conceptualized a sea-launch rocket which significantly reduced the need for complex ground infrastructure. A substantial ballast tank system would be mounted on the first stage engine foundation, allowing the rocket to be lifted into an upright orientation for launch. This design placed the rocket's payload just above the waterline, significantly facilitating access prior to liftoff. Truax had previously evaluated this basic concept through previous efforts, including CB and Seahorse, with encouraging results. The sea launch design was carefully developed using durable yet uncomplicated materials, including 8mm steel sheet, ensuring cost-effectiveness and ease of construction. The rocket was strategically designed to be built in a coastal shipyard from where it would then be towed offshore for launch. A particularly innovative feature of the ocean towing approach was its emphasis on reusability. The system was engineered for passive reentry, facilitating the recovery and repair of rocket segments for subsequent launches. This method had the potential to dramatically lower the costs associated with space launches, positioning ocean towing vehicles as a potentially transformative innovation. However, the ocean towing initiative was eventually shelved. It was launched at a time when the Apollo program was winding down, while the Vietnam War was consuming much of the United States budget. As a result, NASA disbanded its division responsible for future projects, effectively shelving most of its manned Mars landing efforts. However, due to inadequate funding and support, Aerojet, now known as Aerojet Rocketdyne, was forced to shelve the ocean towing concept. While the launch of a spacecraft of that size may not be imminent, the concept is far from forgotten. Musk has expressed interest in the concept of a larger spacecraft. While a Starship variant that surpasses its current specifications is unlikely to materialize for at least a decade, Musk has not completely dismissed the prospect. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next episode.